Is a bird's brain the same as ours?
Well, yes and no. Okay, this is an interesting...
You sound like a lawyer now.
When you look at a bird brain, it looks nothing like our brain. Mm-hmm. Our brain has all these, they're called gyri and sulci. It's all these, you know, it's all these hills and valleys, and it's very complicated looking. You look at a bird's brain, it just looks like a blob of stuff. Okay, very smooth. It turns out that even in the 1900s, Kalischer was doing work showing that there were bird brain areas that seemed to be responsible for intelligent behavior. At the time, they called it a striatal area. It seemed that birds with the larger striatal areas, the parrots, the crows, the jays, would do better on intelligence tests than those birds with the smaller striatal areas relative to the size of the brain. And fast forward to the 1970s, and people started looking at the song learning centers and started realizing that there were centers of song learning that were similar to our language learning centers. Mm-hmm. But I'd still go out and give talks, and people would say, well, there's no cerebral cortex in the avian brain, the part of the brain that's in mammals and primates that's responsible for intelligence. And I'd say, look, I don't know. You go find it, because the bird is doing this stuff, and he's using something to do it. Well, Nature Reviews Neuroscience 2005, Jarvis et al., where et al. Is 20 other neuroscientists, they published showing all this work they'd been doing for a decade, showing that the avian brain has a cortical-like area. It's derived from the same pallial area as the mammalian brain, going back, 280 million years ago to the dinosaurs. And that those birds, like as we knew before, the parrots, the crows, the jays, with the relatively larger area in this brain, again, is responsible for this relatively more intelligent behavior. So it doesn't look like our brain, but it functions like our brain.
This excerpt is brought to you by the Massachusetts School of Law, the leader of reform in legal education and a leader in multimedia education for the public. To view the full interview and for a full listing of MSL's programs, log on to mslaw.edu.